ओम नमस्ते माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट इफ स्टेटमेंट। इफ स्टेटमेंट इज बेसिकली अ डिसीजन कंस्ट्रक्ट स्टेटमेंट, और वी कैन ऑल्सो से इट्स एज अ सिलेक्शन स्टेटमेंट। ओके, लुक एट द स्ट्रक्चर। द सिंपल फॉर्म ऑफ इफ स्टेटमेंट इज अ टेस्ट ऑफ अ कंडीशन। इफ द कंडीशन इज ट्रू देन सम स्टेटमेंट विल बी एग्जीक्यूटेड, इफ द कंडीशन इज फॉल्स देन सम अदर स्टेटमेंट विल बी एग्जीक्यूटेड। नाउ लुक एट द सिंटैक्स। Syntax is there, you have to write the if, this keyword. Next, you have to write the condition. So this is your conditional expression, and there is a one colon, and after that some line will be there, that will be your body part of this if statement. So this if statement is basically a compound statement. If statement is basically a compound statement with a header and a body line. Header is always start with a keyword and end with a colon, that's why if is a keyword and it's end with a colon, and in the body part there will be some other set of statements. Now look at this syntax. Here we check that the character is space or not. So here it's written if ch is a variable name, ch equals to space, so there is one space between these two quotation. So if ch equals to space, then space will be increment by 1, so space plus equals to 1. You can write also this one, space equals to space plus 1. See, space equals to space plus 1, so that means whatever the space value is there, that will be increment by 1, and that final value will be again thrown into space, and it's also increment one character, so chars plus equals to 1. So this is a if statement. This is if statement syntax, and this is one example of the if statement, that is a conditional statements. Go to next page. There is another example, that is we check whatever the number or whatever the character is given by the user, it's a digit or not. So input enter a single character, and we store that value into ch. Ch is a variable. In the place of ch you can write a, b, c, anything. So as we mentioned ch at here, the value is stored into ch variable. Next we check, that is if ch greater than equals to 0 and ch less than equals to 9, then we can say that is a print. In the print statement you enter a digit, that's mean if user is given a value which is more than 0 and less than 9, then we can say that is you enter a digit. Now look at here the 0 and 9 are the both are in the quotation, because input take all the value in a string form, so that's why you have to use the quotation at here for the string type of value. If you write int in this position, like this, you don't need to give this quotation at here. Okay, come to the next example. In this example we check the character is the space or digit. So we take the value using this input statement and we store the value into ch. Now we check if ch equals to space, next print you enter space. If it's not, then it's come to the next if statement, and next if statement is there, that is ch greater than equals to 0 and ch less than equals to 9, then print you enter digit. So this are here we use two different if statements. So this type of thing you can use more, two if statement, three if statement, five if statement. There is no any limit of using if statement, but you have to be very clear about your logic and about your process. Now one more thing is that, see, the body of the if statement is little bit inner, it's in the next level. So if you write this print statement at here, that's mean if you write this print statement from in this position onwards, then this print statement, it will be not in your if statement's body part. So define the body parts, you have to write this statement little bit inner of the previous statements. Yes, focus is little bit disturbed set here. Next look at here we take two value and we check that first value is greater than 10 and the second value is less than b, is less than 15 or not. Now we make some calculation and we write the print statement. Now this print statement is not the these two statements are not the body of this if statement. So if it will be the body of the if statement, you have to write these two statements a little bit inner. And now, and also this print statement is also not the body of if statement, because it's the outer position. The position of the label is the outer than this if statement, in this label basically. Some other syntax or example is there, like this different kinds of statement. This if a, if grade equals to a, then you can say that is print you, in the print statement you did well. If a greater than b, that is you can say a has more value than b. Or if x nothing is there, that means always true, so print x is a truth value, x has truth value as true. So in the if statement we define some condition. It's basically a comparison where we compare grade with a. Here is a comparing two value, we check that is a greater than b, or we can write a less than b, less than b, or less than equals to b. This type of comparing is there. Here we use the relational operator. And next one is the x. If here we define if statement without any condition, so you can define if statement with condition or without condition. Come to the next part. It's basically if else statement. In the previous part I explain you all the if statement when the condition is true, but when the condition is false, then what happen? So for this one, else statement is there. So if the condition is true, then this truth statement will be executed. If the condition is false, then this statement will be executed. So whatever statement is there in the else part, that statement will be executed if the condition is false. Now look at this example, that is if a greater than 0 or greater than equals to 0, then we can say that is print a is 0 or positive number, otherwise we can say that is a is a negative number. So in this program or in this statement, we can check a number is positive or negative. So this is your one question, that is check a number is positive or negative. It's a simple program. This type of question can come in your exam. Let's check a number is positive or not. Write the code. You have to write this one. That is, if a greater than equals to 0, print a is 0 or positive number, otherwise a is a negative number. But you also have to take value from the user. So you have to define the input statement like this. Input enter a value or enter a single character like this. That value you have to add in this position. Otherwise, if you check only the if statement, then look this two statement only. Okay, so if user is given 7, then it will be print that is 7 is a 0 or positive number. If the user is given minus 5, then it will be print that is minus 5 is a negative number. Now go to next page. This is your first program, that is program number 4.1. In this program, here is defined, or the question is, that is program to accept 3 integer and print the largest of the 3. Make use only if statement. So here it's defined that it say that's using only if statement. No else statement is there. So using only if statement, find out the largest number among 3. So if you look at the pseudo code, here is written as input 3 number xyz max equals to x. That's mean we store first value into max variable and we check that is second value y is more than max or not. If it's more than max, then we store y value into max variable. Then we check another value, then we check third value with the max variable, that is z is more than max or not. If it is, then we store z value into max variable, and in finally we display the max value as the largest number. Look at the flowchart also. So start statement, we take 3 value using this input x, so we write it here, that is input xyz. Next we store the value x into max, If there is a condition, if y greater than max, then we store y value into max, otherwise we will go to next condition. And the condition is, that is, we check, that is, if z greater than max, if yes, then we store z value into max, otherwise we will go to the next statement. Next statement, that is, in that statement we print the largest number is max. This can be x, this can be y, or it can be z, and it's end with the stop statement. Now come to the coding part. The first line, that is x equals to y equals to z equals to 0, that means we store 0 into x, y and z. Next we take 3 value from the user using input statement, and we want float type of value, means floating point, decimal point value. That's why we define float at here. If we need only integer type of value like 2, 3, 4, 5 without decimal point, then you just write int in this position. In the position of float, you can write int. So here we take 3 value from the user and we store the value into x, y, z. Next, it's written, that is, max equals to x. That's when we store x value into max. Next, we check if y greater than max. Next, we store y into max. So the code is max equals to y. Next we check if z equals to z greater than max, then we store z value into max, and finally we print, that is, the largest number is max. So read this code more and more, write this code in your rough copy. One thing is that, students, I want to share you, that is, no code is fixed for any kinds of program. Writing programs or writing code is very creative thing. So same program you can write in a different way using different statement. I can show you 2 or 3 form only for this program. It is find out the largest number among 3. One statement is there. So first you have to understand this statement. You have to understand the logic. Your logic should be very clear. It's a statement or number of line, it can be different, but your logic, it should be very clear and it should be very correct. Okay, so write this code in your, this is your question for 4.1, and this is your code in Python, this is your answer. So write this thing in your computer lab copy, and this is your output. This one is your output. OP means it's basically is your output. Write this thing also in your computer lab copy. Come to the next program, that is program number 4.2. Here we check, we take one number from the user and we check the number is odd or even. So if you give 2, then it will be show it's a even number, and if you give 5, then it will be show it's a odd number. Now look at the code. We take value from the user using this input statement. So enter an integer, it's an integer type of value, and we store the value into this num variable. Next we check that if num modulus 2 equals to equals to 0, that's mean whatever the value is given by the user, that value is divided by 2, and we check the remainder is 0 or not. If the remainder is 0, then we can say it's an even number, otherwise we can say it's an odd number. So whatever the number is given by the user, if the number is divisible by 2 and the remainder is 0, then we can say it's an even number, otherwise it's a number is an odd number. So look, practice this code also in your rough copy more and more. Try to write this code without looking at your book. First you have to read this one, but don't memorize the logic. Basically don't memorize the code, that first this statement will be there, next this statement, not like this way. You have to understand the logic. Okay, so this is the first time when you are going to write some coding, so it will be a little bit difficult for you, but later when you are become an expert, it's a very easy way for you. If you get an interest on it, then only. Okay, program 4.0 is a little bit hard program, so I'm not explaining this one right now. Come to program number 4.4. Here we take 2 value from the user and check that the number is divisible by or not, by another number or not. So we take 2 value from the user and we store the value into number 1, number 2. Number 1, number 2 as a variable, it's a basically identifier. In this place you can define a, B or N1, N2 like this. So there is no any kind of fixed, that you have to always store any value into a number or into A. You can write also P and Q like this. It's your choice what you want to write. Next, so we take two value from the user. Now we check, that's the number 1 modulus number 2, and we store the value into remainder. And next we check that if remainder equals to 0, then we can say this number 1 is divisible by number 2. Otherwise else part is there, where we can print this number 1 is not divisible by number 2. And this is your output portion. This is your output portion. Enter first number. Suppose you given 119, it show like this. Enter second number. If you give the number is 3, like it will be show like this. And then it will be print as number is not divisible by 3. In the place of 3, if you would have given 17, then it will be print that is this first number is divisible by second number. Okay, so this one, write this program also in your lab copy. 4.4 4.6, this program is also very simple program. This also a 5-6 lines, 7 lines program is there. Write this program also in your computer lab copy. It's very simple. So calculating the area of the perimeter of a circle. So first you take the radius from the users. Next you give to print statement, print 1, print 2. Next you take choice, that choice is 1 or not. If choice is 1, then you have to find out the area, and the blue formula is, that is, you have to multiply this value with radius square. Square means you have to repeat radius 2 times. So that's why multiplication radius, again multiplication radius. Otherwise you can also write this one, this 3.141559 into radius double multiplication 2. So it will become the power, radius into radius. See, this statement you can also write this one. So there is no any kind of fixed statement for any program. I can write program according to my choice. I can change the statement, but the answer or the logic should be clear. That's the main thing of writing a program. So write this, practice this program 4.1, 4.2, 4.4 and 4.6. when you understand this program properly, then you will see program 4.5 and 4.3. Om Namah Shivaya students.